Mr. Kapoor, are you awake?
They told me you spent the night here. Guess we never did finish our talk.
No, I just wanted to make sure you were okay. You surprised me yesterday. If I'd have known you were gonna do that.
That I didn't kill her.
I believed you before you jumped.
Look, what I did. People might think it was because I really did hurt Dr. Reed. I don't want that. All I can tell you about that night is that I was at a meeting that is covered by a non-disclosure agreement. I know how that must sound, but if the details get out, $1 billion company's stock goes in the toilet. I could get sued. My boss, Mr. Place, is supposed to be coming here at 9 with some documents that he wants me to look over. Talk to him. He'll tell you I'm telling the truth.
I'm Sherlock Holmes. I work with the police. You might be aware I questioned your employee, Mr. Kapoor, yesterday regarding the murder of his therapist. Today he told me I should talk to you about where he was 2 nights ago. You might not care that he tried to take his own life yesterday, but I do, so would you do us both the great favor of confirming that he has an alibi?
He was with me.
Where?
A meeting.
We brokered a sit-down between the CEO of a prominent company and a certain Antiguan bank.
Antiguan, lovely. Known for its barely legal tax shelters.
I won't be naming the CEO or the bank, but I can arrange for the police to see security video of Alphonse coming and going.
Well, that would do the trick.
I do care about him, you know. Alphonse, he's special. Goes for a tax code like a fishmonger through a carp. I care about Candace, too.
You knew her?
I'm the one who referred Alphonse.
So she was your doctor as well?
No. She was my tenant. I own the building her offices are in. When she applied for a lease, I found out she had a great reputation and a long waiting list. So in exchange for seeing Alphonse, I knocked a few months off her rent.
Very economical of you.
Are you talking to her partner, Dr. Demopoulos?
Perhaps. Why?
Candace had to cover his rent a few times last year, and other tenants complained that they could hear them arguing sometimes, and I don't know. Alphonse isn't your guy. Maybe Dr. Demopoulos is?
She. My therapist. Right. You're kidding, right?
I wish I was.
Are you okay?
I think I left my checkbook in the kitchen.
Joan, you just told me this woman was your therapist. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm sorry. I hadn't seen her in a long time. I'm fine.
You don't look fine.
I think I made a mistake this morning. I looked at something I shouldn't have.
Was it these pictures?
I got access to her file on me, and I read something that I wasn't expecting.
What? Did she think you were a serial killer or something?
She thought I would have been a good mother.
She kept on you.
Listen, I know that I shouldn't have done it. I just was curious.
Joni, sweetie, if there were notes on me, I would have read them at the crime scene. Patient has strong maternal urges, which she channels into her job rather than facing her fears of actually becoming a mother. You were a sober companion back then, right? You were helping addicts in recovery. But this woman never told you she thought you were channeling urges?
Therapists don't just come out and tell you what they think. They want to help you figure it out for yourself. It's more impactful that way.
She never asked you whether you wanted kids.
She did. But that was in our getting to know you phase. I mean, it's not the reason I started seeing her.
Well, what did you tell her?
I told her I hadn't thought about it much.
Was that because of Dad?
What do you mean?
Was Dad one of the reasons why you didn't think about it much? You knew there was a chance you could have a kid with schizophrenia.
You are my therapist today.
I worry about it whenever I think about kids. How could we not?
I mean, that was part of it. Yeah, but also I wasn't seeing anyone back then. I mean, kids weren't really on the horizon. I mean, that was 5 years ago. I mean, I don't know. I guess just reading all that stuff made me think that I missed out on something.